नमस्कार. प्रुडंट मिडियाच्या गजाली कार्यावळीन तुमकां सगळ्यांक येवकार. आयज आमचे कडेन गजाली करपाक आयल्यात भारताचे सारके फामाद अशे ॲस्ट्रोफिजिसिस्ट डॉक्टर जयंत नाळीकर.
नमस्कार.
वंडरफुल टू हॅव यू हियर सर.
थँक्यू.
वी हॅव ऑलवेज सीन दॅट युअर बुक्स हॅव बीन लव्ड बाय यंग स्टुडंट्स अँड आय एम शुअर यू हॅव कम हियर फॉर द डी डी कोसंबी Festival
right.
of Ideas,
yes.
And a lot of young children are going to be there. My first question is, these children learn in schools from science teachers. Is the education system really linked correctly to science?
Frankly speaking, I don't think. Science should be taught, not as a series of rules or laws to be learnt and memorized. But it is something which you have picked up by observing nature. So one is encouraged, or one should be encouraged, to look at nature and ask questions, and then try to find answers. So questions should be spontaneous, and answers should be natural with respect to those questions, not something that you tell the student, don't ask questions, this is not the right way. Rather, one should say that ask as many questions as you like and I will try to answer. So the teacher should be accommodative in terms of inviting questions from students.
So now every child is born with an open mind, with a questioning mind, and this was possibly in 1975 enshrined in our constitution through an Article 51H, which encouraged as a fundamental duty the spirit of humanism, spirit of inquiry.
Yes.
So, 75, it happened, but has it come in our country?
Well, we make rules and laws, but if it is not the mindset of the person that is changed, the rules and laws are simply on paper. So that is what has happened. One should encourage questions. And I have made this suggestion from several forums that I speak on, that in each school, there should be one period in the whole week when nothing but questions are invited from students and teacher answers. If they don't find the answers, or if the teacher says, I don't know the answer, he should be able to admit that. It's not that he is therefore inferior or in any case inadequate. The spirit of finding the answer should also be there. So one should look into the websites, encyclopedias and so on, and find the answer. So this is what one should do. Just one period in a week will show lot of improvement.
Very true. But there is also this, there are entire communities which don't have access to education or which drop out from the education system. So what can be done for them?
I think that is a much wider question. We need to make them or their parents feel that education is necessary. It is value addition, which is priceless in certain sense, and it has to be, they have to be told or educated into believing that education is important.
Right. We have also seen a lot of science professionals, people who study science at college level because they need to and they get qualified as science professional. We find quite often them not having a scientific temper, like they are using the benefits of science but they are not fully accepting science.
Yes, I think unfortunately, I mean, you mentioned people who were taught science and so on. I would say even scientists who are professional scientists working in their lab, they may be scientists there. Once they come out and go home, they switch over and all this scientific effect is gone and they become what I would call superstitious like any other non-scientist.
Would it be fair to say that a lot of this happens because people who may be propagating scientific temper and rational thought are sometimes away from philosophy, which appeals to the spiritual side of people?
I think on the whole, when you want to make somebody scientifically literate or scientifically tempered, it is not something you tell him or her that you are on the wrong track, change your direction. I give the example of a story which I learned at school, and you must have also done that, that there was a competition between the sun and the wind as to who is more powerful. So they decided that there was a man walking on the street with a coat on. Whoever makes him remove the coat is more powerful. So the wind blew hard and hard, and the man then realized he needs to hold it more tightly. So he held on to it and didn't let it go. The sun shone very steadily and it became hotter and hotter, and he took away the coat. Now, in the same way, if you tell somebody that he is superstitious and he should not do it and sort of be more commanding, then he will hold on to the superstition, not let it go. And if you are more persuasive, give him the evidence of why it is a superstition and not a real fact of life, then he may be persuaded to give it up. I think that is the approach one should follow.
This storytelling that you so wonderfully do, you have put it in so many books, you have made it very simple and easy for people to get connected to an open mind and scientific temper. Any more books that you intend to write?
Well, I am planning to write a book which gives you the story of mathematics and science right from early days when man was beginning to become more and more civilized, right to the present time, in which I want to give the example that mathematics or physics as taught in the school, physics or science as taught in the school, is given as a ready-made package. But to make that package in that form, lot of people have spent their lives and their collective wisdom has come in that packet. And it has not been easy to attain that packet, because sometimes you go the wrong way, come back and find the right way. So scientists and mathematicians are, after all, human. They make mistakes. They may take wrong views. But afterwards, they come back because they are guided by scientific temper that anything that is going to work ultimately has got to be the right approach. So that I want to emphasize in this book. So hopefully this will carry some message.
Yes. Also, I wanted to ask you, Maharashtra recently, after Dabolkar was brutally murdered.
Yes.
They somehow found the trigger to pass the anti-superstition bill. Doesn't the entire country require something to protect the people from very dangerous practices which are looting them as well as cheating them?
Well, on the one hand, I would say that, as you very rightly said, why one state only, but the whole country should have some such law. And Dabolkar was very keen that this would make a beginning towards eradication of superstitions. So I would say that this is certainly required. But at the same time, I would also say it is not sufficient. The mindset has to change, individual mindset. And that many times may not happen just by passing laws. So laws are necessary but not sufficient. This is my view.
So you obviously mean there's a lot of work that needs to be done with the community, through the community.
Educative work has to be done.
So any such models that you have seen over your travels, not only in India, around the world?
Well, if I give the example of Royal Institution in London, which was started by Faraday, Michael Faraday, the famous physicist. Now, he used to give public lectures to the public, general public, as well as special lectures to school students. And I have read some of the transcripts of what he said, and they are really worth reading. They have been translated also in Marathi. So I found that they are examples of how one should communicate science and the thrill of science to the general public. And not only thrill of science, but the scientific thinking. Why something is right, why something is wrong. So that kind of teaching should be carried out by some of our leading scientific laboratories. For example, when I set up our center in Pune, the IUCA, Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, public outreach of science was put as part of the mandates of IUCA. So that has proved to be very, very valuable. We do have direct contact with a lot of public as well as school children. I think more institutions should do this.
And here there is that question also, is like possibly like coming back to the science teachers again. We notice a lot of science teachers just teach the subject, you know, like, and there are science teachers who take part in the larger sphere. In fact, we have seen even other teachers, you know, from non-science subjects who seem very interested in science. What is it that needs to change in the education system to ensure that science doesn't get taught only in science subjects, gets taught all over?
See, science should be taught as a subject which arose from human inquiry into nature. And that is a game which we are supposed to be playing with nature. Mm-hmm. Nature hides lot of its secrets. We try to look for it, like hide and seek. Somebody has hidden something, you go and find it. So that particular secret you have to find. So after you have found that secret, then you are introduced to something new. New secret. Find that. So this kind of game, if science is taught as a part of that quest, general quest, I think it will be a much more interesting subject than being taught as a series of mantras which you memorize, produce in the exam, and then forget.
Yeah. Thank you. Here we'll take a small break. आम्ही आता एक लहानसं विसव घेता, पळत रवात प्रुडंट मीडिया.